Hey all, this is Urs, and welcome back to XCOM 2. After the 2-hour stream we posted, man, there were some rough missions in there, I gotta say. Our first retaliation mission, that really kinda sucked, and it really kinda beat us up, I gotta say. But you know what that means? I mean, the more troops we utilize.
We're still seeing a steady flow of migrants heading into the cities.
I'm not sure they have to do all that much convincing at this point.
And I'm not sure I'd trade my freedom for a few hot meals and the cure for the common cold.
Well, maybe not. But what about the terminally ill, the elderly, or the disabled? The aliens can offer them something we can't. Something most people would trade anything for.
You're wrong about that, Doctor. We can offer them freedom, even if it means they have to endure the pains of being human.
I just hope they see it that way.
That's a good point, actually. It's an interesting conversation. But as I was saying, we had some rough losses, but you know what that means? It just means more characters being cycled into. So again, if you still see your name up here and you have a particular customization you want me to send your way, do it. Tell me. Use my email, my contact information on the About page, and you can tell me exactly how you want to look. And welcome to our 4 new rookies. Dark Cobra Jacket, Dr. Stupcro. Rico with a 0, but it's not coming up very well. And VNZ Death Nacion. Sorry, there wasn't a Filipino flag. I tried. I really did. But yeah, so if you see your characters, you want them customized some kind of special way, you let me know and I will get to it. But anyway, now that that is done, as we keep adding more and more to our ranks, the only question remains, am I going to get a mission with my sharpshooter? Am I going to be able to go on a goddamn mission with my sharpshooter?
Commander, we've got local resistance forces waiting to make contact.
Not now. First, we got to do this.
First move.
First, I want this 150 supplies. This, I need the supply drop, and I need to get that. Because I'm a little shy in supplies, and I want to keep building stuff. Let's get that. I just realized also, we should have probably picked up people from the, HQ.
Only further our advances, Commander.
All right, what do we got?
Sectoid's rapid physical evolution.
Ooh, psionics. Interesting.
Is a testament to both the aliens'
mastery
of
your clone
engineering.
You're a clone.
And their pursuit of advancement.
Trust you, man.
Regardless of the risks.
All right, so we have apparently mind shield, immune to any negative mental conditions. Wow, really? We can make one of those? Son of a bitch, that's pretty cool. No, we can't do psionics. Waiting for this 10 Illyrium crystals. That's gonna be a little while. 15 alloys. Alright. We can do the faceless autopsy. Take us a little while. We can do the Avant Trooper autopsy. Magnetic weapons, still a little long time. Even with the scientists. We can do resistance comms. I feel like we need to start learning about resistance comms. We want to take that black site mission on. But we're not going to be able to build one without power, and that's going to take a little while. So let me get at least the Advent Trooper autopsy
Knowing
rolling.
That my path to surgical experience is limited.
Yeah, no kidding.
I
using a freaking
sure
Dremel
you
tool.
Yeah. I hone my skills on fallen Advent forces before triaging our own wounded.
Yeah.
To the uninitiated, the common Advent Trooper is seemingly human. The aliens have disguised this most glaring divergence from the human form with a carefully designed helmet.
Yeah, that's all kinds of fucked up there, man. That's just, fuck, I don't know. Those autopsies are making me freak a little bit. Anyway, we got that working. Yeah. I know I'm listening here. Got the supply drop done. Okay, I want to go back to HQ because I know there's a couple people here. And then I'll try to pick up those a little bit. It was maybe a little waste of time. I should have done this early, but you know, I said, we're still learning here. New staff. All right, engineers and veteran soldiers.
Additional resources and staff at Resistance
headquarters.
Welcome, Commander. Use.
So we don't have engineers. We need 170 supplies from Mary Stone. Hector Diaz, Grenadier, again. 170 supplies. Rapid construction. Ah, I see. So this will either help people recover from injuries faster. Purchasing's ability to override the current Resistance HQ scanning bonus will only be modified one per month. Ah, I see. So if I'm sitting here scanning, I can buy these things and it'll help me produce or heal up my soldiers. Interesting. Well, my main goal is to get my freaking guerrilla tactics school up as quickly as possible. We're still 5 days off of it, so I can start training my rookies into classes I need, and that's going to be a very rapid thing. Let's go over to the supplies here, and then if we start scanning back at Resistance HQ, we'll figure it out.
Avenger plotting new course.
So, we do have a scientist there, which I kind of want. It's going to help our tech, but really, tech isn't what we're behind on. We're behind on engineering. I want to kind of save my supplies for that. Start scanning here. New target acquired. View the target. Operation Banished Whale. It counters the dark event of increases detection radii of all enemies, 164 supplies, and we need to destroy the alien relay. Alright, I mean, let me ignore it for a second. How much time do I have on this one? I don't know if how much time I actually have on this, how long it stays up. Because I need my troopers to be back up, and I can't go into this mission without at least three educated troopers, so to speak. Because right now, we're shy on assaults, and... Oh, my sharpshooter is actually available. Okay, so... I don't know if it's going to last for 6 days. I'm guessing guerrilla ops don't hang around that long. So as much as I want my ranger, I'm not going to have a choice. I'm going to go into the grenadier, specialist, and the sharpshooter. And a rookie. So Tank Campbell's going to get his first go on this. Seems like the only thing to do at this point. I still need my guerrilla tactics school. Once I have that, things will be better, but it seems like they're not really giving me much of a break here. So do we have a choice to stop this? Next retaliation strikes in 4 weeks. Okay, estimated. So I'm glad I'm gonna have a little bit of time before that shit happens again. So this will counter the... Yeah, this will counter the vigilance one, I think. There's nothing active yet. And this, like it says, counters the Vigilance Guerrilla op here. Counters Vigilance. Yeah, you know, let's confirm now. Let's take that on. As fun as that is, maybe I should be scanning here. If anyone knows exactly how long these things last, let me know. I'll have a better idea of what I need to be doing with my time. Gotta feel like it's important. Alrighty. Let's build out here. First mission with a sharpshooter. Just watch her get killed in the first move. Oh, I don't even want to think about that. Alright, so Robert Ortiz is out of there, can't use him, so Tank Campbell, you're about to come into the mission. I think this kit that I had before makes sense. We absolutely need to keep at least one flashbang on our cannoneer that keeps us alive, more or less, with the range too, and then we're going to keep the explosives here, especially on Campbell here. He's a newbie, he's going to need to clear up some cover while the rest of us try and kill stuff. That's my plan, at least. We're not going to have a Phantom here. That's a real downer. Heavy loss we took last mission, but I can't do much about that. Let's just launch this one and hope we survive. Possible Iron Man, yo. Apparently it's hard. Go figure. Some bad RNG and, you know, you're staring at another dead trooper. We had one really good luck, though, honestly. We had that one huge piece of luck with the nasty Lovecrafting abomination trying to relocate our faces a little bit. Rat Town in Bloemfontein, eh? Nice.
We have to take advantage of every opportunity to disrupt the aliens' progress on their latest operation. So we're moving in to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. Don't leave any hostiles standing.
Alright, so stop the relay, but also kill everything. That sounds pretty much par for the course for XCOM territory. So how do we disable the relay? Do we need to hack it or need to blow it up? To destroy. Wonder if we can hack it for some kind of good benefits. I don't know. Like I said, all these missions are new to me at this point, so this is all gravy. All cool gravy. Rookie's like, why am I the only one wearing a helmet? This seems unnecessary. Why am I defending myself like this? I don't know, man. That's your choice. That's a personal choice. Helmets are a personal choice. And we're gonna fast line down here, and here we are.
1-5. The communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
Our position is concealed.
Got 8 turns for the data transfer. Alright, it doesn't have that many hit points, so once we get there, looks like it could be okay. We just gotta be a little careful. This looks like it could be chock full of civilians. We are kinda in slums here. Civilians love slums. No, they don't. It's just sometimes they don't have a choice. Don't be racist. Don't be an ass. Absolutely true. Not racist. Classist, I guess, would be more correct. What is... Pistol Overwatch concealed. Oh, interesting. So we got Pistol Overwatch or Overwatch with our main gun. Fascinating. I'm assuming sniper rifles work the same way as sniper rifles used to, and you can't take a shot. So and since you can't steady on sniper rifles, yeah, I'm thinking that's the way it goes. All right, I'm gonna assume they work the same way. Then I'm dead wrong. That'd be really funny, wouldn't it? That would actually be really, really sad. Since apparently last time when we were not in full cover... Okay, what do we have here? What would cause this? Oh, the door would cause this. We're gonna keep advancing here and being covered by our sniper. If I can get her up on this roof at some point, that'd be good. I'm gonna keep her on this roof while I have it. If I see any advent forces, I'm gonna try to take some cover here. It's just, I don't wanna get caught out in the open. Last time we did that, we lost a soldier. It was really, really, really sad. So you know what we're gonna test the rounds with? Rookie! So why is it always me? Because you're a rookie.
Moving on target location.
What do we got? We got some pigeons up there, freaky pigeons.
Without the introduction of human DNA,
we got a snake person.
These creatures operating under the guise of Fin Men now show their true form.
Fin Men.
A purely reptilian species.
No reason for them to hide. The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
But didn't we actually have an infiltration unit in that giant abomination from hell? Yeah, so we do have squad sight on that one. It's just... we can't fire. So if it moves out, we'll have a pistol overwatch. I think makes sense. Yeah, it's kind of weird not having the steady, honestly. It's quite weird to me, but... alright, since we're pretty close to something... that's not... is it going to give me eyes? That's not going to give me corner. This is the only thing that's going to give me actual eyes. But again, no cover means I don't want to be up there. I may spot from the roof, though. It makes sense to stay on the roof with most people, and we'll use our rookie for everything else. Please don't break anything. Yeah, we'll set up the ambush, I think, from the roof. We can handle that first pack. Again, we're still concealed, and we don't think we see anything. What's this? That's a scanner tower. Okay, it's not another pack right now. Let's get on the corners here. I think we're going to take the moves up in this corner, and we're going to get eyes on all these nasty little buggers.
Will do.
Okay, we're going to probably have to go loud pretty quickly here. We only have 8 turns for this. Last time we had a VIP extraction, it gave us 12. This looks like it could get worse. What is this? Is this a civvy that can see us? Or maybe it's the snake individual. Snake dude, snake lady, snake... I don't know, snake thing. Snake man! But it's not really masculine, right? Like, there's some weird stuff floating around about people getting turned on by snake things. I don't know, it's kind of fucked up. We have 2 combat protocols, too, I gotta remember. Which gives us the flexibility to break Overwatch at will, since it's guaranteed damage. Just in case something weird happens, I want to have at least an Overwatch and pistol, because we got nothing. And they walked away? Don't you walk away from me! Alright, rookie. Rookie, find them for me.
Moving to designated position.
Okay, we have eyes again. Oh, we have eyes on the snick. We have snick eyes. Alright, do we have a shot on the snick? You have no shot on snick? Do you have shot on snick? You have no shot on snick, why? Why do you have a shot on the snake? This looks like a really good shot on the snake, actually. You should have a shot on the snake. Within your line of sight. I see. So we could try to overwatch with our sniper rifle. That may not work out so well, because I don't think it's actually... Or we could drop down here, use this as our ambush position, and then use our sniper to clean up when they move forward. Yeah, I want to get this going in a big way right now. Let's get our grenadier out here. Get our specialist up top. Where's the other vision? Yeah, okay, that's how the vision's working. Yeah, I think we're going to take that ambush that way. Yeah, planning these ambushes seems to be really, really important. I'm just saying. You have a shot there. Why don't you have a shot there? It's going to move forward on us, though. Then we'll probably have a nice sniper shot. See what we can pull off on this. I almost feel like not putting my grenadier on Overwatch so we can get a beautiful, beautiful flank off on this. Okay, nice. So we have eyes on... now we have eyes on both operators. It may not be a bad idea to start off with a grenade. Not from our grenadier, but our rookie. Why does our grenadier not have eyes on this? This is kind of bizarre. The height advantage is going to help regardless. Okay. But I think we got to get this moving. I really do. Okay. So what's going to happen is that rookie's going to start off with a grenade. Can we get both of them down? No, we can't. We can just activate that feller. And the snek is the more dangerous one, I think. So I keep saying it that way, but you just kind of have to say it that way. So we can try to do a little bit of snakey-snakey there, and... I mean, even if it takes full cover, we should be okay with this. So let's take the clean shot, then. Let's take the clean shot with the rookie. We'll set Overwatch is here. We'll leave the grenadier to maybe break cover if need be, so we can take a clean shot with the sniper. So we're going to set one epic Overwatch, and we're going to activate with the rook. What's your aim, rook? 67 on the Viper. We may get a cleaner kill on... the adventure for 75. Yeah, I think I may take that shot, actually. Okay, that's my plan. I'm gonna take the 75 with my specialist. I'm gonna put the Rook on... Yeah, I'm gonna put the Rook on Overwatch, maybe? In case something peels out of there. Or I'll take... Yes, that way Ziggy can toss a grenade if we need to, no matter where it is, and we'll clean that up. Okay, that's my plan. That's my plan, I'm sticking to it. Yeah, I like that. Though then again, having a full shot Overwatch with a big cannon may be better. Alright, you know what? Rock that Overwatch. Rookie should be able to clear the grenade where we need to. Let the sniper do its thing once we have vision on stuff. And Seresh is going to try to save the grenade and take the 75 here. Alright, we got to plan this out because we don't have a nice shot on everything here. And that's the shank. That's awful.
Not good.
Not what I wanted to happen. At all.
We're in their sight.
Yes, we are. That's creepy. That's a slippery little snake.
Shot wide.
Shot wide. So this is what I was counting on. Our snipers now. What is flanked by all these things? What are we flanking, really? Who has these guys flanked? I don't think anyone does. I think maybe an artifact. Yeah. 55 is a shot from our sniper. Rookie's got some work to do to clean up this snake here. Can we actually get this broken? Oh, that's actually permacover. It's kind of scary. Don't like that so much. Would be nice to blow this dude up, though. Clear that up, at least get a sniper kill. I'm a little worried about the snake now, because we didn't get any kills out. This is not destructible cover. These lampposts are made of freaking adamantium. Okay, let me rephrase that. It's destructible, but it may set off the car. I have to point blank that to destroy it. Are you serious right now? I mean, I'll have a turn to get away from it? I don't know. It's complicated. Difficult decision. What I may do is see if I can at least take the advent out, because if I get double flanked, I'm going to be hella pissed. Let's go right there and get him down, or get that cover blown.
Grenade out!
So we can get that shot with our sniper, or we can get that kill, and then whatever. Of course not. We always roll three when it's important, because we just like rolling that number. Odd numbers are real! 95%. Good. Take that shot. I'll take that 95 on a sniper rifle. What's up? Nice. Okay, so now the snakey's gonna do the snakey thing. I've never fought a snake before, so let's see what happens. In real life or in XCOM. Like, I just don't really go out and punch snakes in the face a lot. Are you on Overwatch? No, it did not appear to be on Overwatch. I think the snake just pooped itself. Really? Okay. You're on the ground floor in this billiard hall, whatever the hell it is. Okay, so yeah, about that. Well, we can try to get some nice flanks on the snake, and we should be all right. There may be more packs out here, but I don't see much. This is going to give us a flank on the snake. Okay, I think we can actually handle this pretty well. Where is our gunner? Yeah, our gunner can't quite get there, but our gunner can get up to this flank. And if we can avoid the grenade... The question is, can we avoid the grenade? Let's see if we can get a good shot on the rookie here. That's like a bad joke, but you know what I mean. Let's get you as close as you can go.
Affirmative. Moving out.
You have no more grenades, so you can at least take shots now. 74%. All right. I'll take that swing, honestly. I will. Dodge. Grazed. Okay, this is becoming problematic. I am not happy about this. This is my not very happy right now face. All right, what I'm going to probably need to do is move my specialist out of there. And if we could clear that pole, I'd be very happy. Let's get that going with a grenade. Can we get that pole without blowing up the car? Like, I have to do it this way for some reason. Not sure why that pole needs to be point blanked with a grenade. Man, I even break the pole, honestly. Shoot. Why'd you have to graze? Why'd you have to dodge, freaky snake thing? I can point blank this damn thing, but that defeats the purpose of getting my sniper involved. Alright, I'm gonna get away from here.
Heading out.
Then I'm gonna grenade it with my grenadier. My highest probability of actually doing this right. I should start with our specialist. We have a bigger gun in the grenadier. This looks pretty good. I want this pole to go away. That's the most important thing for me right now. If that goes away, then I am happy. Please do this.
Grenade!
Grenade! It is! What that saying? Grenade! Pole is still there. So we got a 55 on this. Not a flashbang, a real one. Why am I using so many grenades on this? This is ridiculous. Like, how hard is it to really kill a snake thing? That pole better go away now. Come on.
Frag out!
There we go. Now it's flanked. Frickin' finally. All right, you. The large gun and the 95% chance to hit. Please clean this damn thing up. There we go. That was unnecessarily complicated. I do not approve. Boom. Not boom, it already blew up. Okay. I was waiting for the big boom, it didn't happen. So I do want to kind of stay up here, but this is all on fire now, thanks to me. So let's keep moving nice and slow, and I mean, we're going to have to start moving quicker soon, but we probably will have eyes on this sooner rather than later. We've used most of our explosives, so I don't know how that's going to go, but we can break it up. That'll be good. So, specialist. I mean, can we actually remote hack? I don't know. I've never tried. Never thought about that. What do we see?
Got some advent here.
Okay, just troopers. All right, they're covering the goods. How's our sniper looking? Sniper's looking like she's got squad sight. 63, 57. All right, I think we can take that shot. Yeah. Let's take that swing. Let's take that swing, I think. Nice. Beautiful kill. Having a sharpshooter would have been so much better.
Looks like something over here.
Yeah, looks like it got a little something in there. That's pretty cool. Tank Campbell, how you gonna go? How you gonna go, son? Get the high ground? Get the high ground advantage? Do a little bit of work that way? I think so. Yeah, I think we're gonna try to go high ground advantage on these guys. It is only half cover, but it's gonna give us a better shot at most of this. And Ziggy's gonna be able to drop a decent overwatch from here.
Order's confirmed, on the move.
On the move. We got no eyes, but that's okay. I didn't expect the range on the eyes here. Or the range against the machine. And Sedesh. Zedash is in half cover, which is not great. The aim is 52 and 52 respectively. There's no officers here, so this makes my life a little easier. But I think our rookie does need to do some dynamo moves, get on the roof. And then we can maybe get some good shots on these guys. It wouldn't be bad. It's not going to be flanks, but it is going to be decent. 68 and 66. That's pretty good. So we can handle the guy who's pretty close here. Give me that 68. Yeah, give me that 68. My dogs are excited about the 68, can't you tell? And we're just not connecting. It's okay.
Get it together.
Get it together, indeed. I need you to get it together right now. Ziggy's going to be able to drop fire down this lane. The only thing with Sedesh is that I can't really combat protocol much. We'd have to overwatch, so let's go overwatch from here.
Come get some.
All right, we're going to overwatch from there, and aid protocol wouldn't be bad. Or we can maybe drop another overwatch if they move. Let's use overwatch and see if they run into it face first. Yeah, that's a good idea. Is this going to overwatch trap me again? Oh, son of a... No kidding, it didn't feel good. So she took 3 damage. That's not great. Overwatch removed. Alright. Let's reload the gun. Okay, so it works similar to the other sniper rifle that we can't take shots. Alright, so that's the one downside. Alright, tank. Tank Campbell, we gotta get you moving, son, because these guys are apparently becoming pains in the ass. Gotta remove that overwatch if we can. We may need to do some aid protocol for that. I mean, aid protocol. Combat protocol. Both things still see her, which is not cool. Let's get combat protocol there. Requires line of sight, apparently, so we got to do this way. This will clear the overwatch, and this is why I got combat protocol in the first place, so I can run up the overwatch without worrying about it too much. Zappy zappy, little dude. Zappy zappy. Okay, that's what I needed to see. I needed that overwatch gone. Once we have that, things get easier. The Sedash is really, really close to biting it. I want to keep my high ground advantage of my sniper, though. She still sees dudes. All right, Ziggy, what you got? I may need to flashbang real quick. That's no cover. That is definitely not... That is a floating wall piece. Again, alien architecture at its finest. I have no idea how they are able to do that. Do they have eyes on any of this just rushing up here? Let's see. They should have eyes on that one. Maybe I'll actually get a flashbang where I want it to make life for Sedash that much easier. Sedash, can you still do stuff? Or is combat protocol a one-time thing? Now, you can use aid protocol first, I guess. We have 49. It's probably not going to do it. But to keep everyone safe, I'm probably going to try to flashbang these guys. Yeah, there we go.
Take this!
Take it in the face.
I want to try to get... This is also the first Advent artifact I'd be able to get. We've been pretty unlucky with our rolls on that stuff. And I feel like... Let me get... This make it a little safer for Tank to get up here. What do we see in there? Oh, just the thing. I was like, oh my gosh, another pack. You know, that's the thing we're trying to shoot. No flanks are going to be possible yet. Yeah, Tank Team was just a little too shy on that. But we should still have... Yeah, we still have vision on everything from up here.
Moving on target.
Good. And what do we have? 72 now and 68. If I can clear the 68... Because we can clear the 72 with the combat protocol, no problem. Let's try to take the 68 down. Yeah, alright. Let's figure that out. 72 is nice, but the 68, if I can clean him up, then we're good. That guy can't get away then. Yeah, a little bit of not so much there. It's kind of what our troops are doing right now. A little bit of not so much.
My ammo's running low.
All right, Rebecca Wildchild. Yeah, just stick up there. You're the best shot we have at actually hitting things. So, I mean, Pistol Overwatch is not going to do anything for our sniper right now, but let's see what we've got handy here. So I don't want to waste a combat protocol again if I don't have to. But if they overwatch camp me again, it'll be the same. Okay, there we go. So you're now flankable. Yeah, if that connected with the flashbang, I would have been furious. So we'll probably get the rookie to come in here and flank and kill and get the artifact as well. That'd be nice. Are you going to get to a place where my sniper can see you? No, it doesn't look like it's going to be possible. What? 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 Come on. Through the flashbang? Oh, dude. Are you kidding me right now? Threw a flashbang? That's why I threw the flashbang. So they couldn't hit people. Are you freaking kidding me right now? That's ridiculous, man.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Enter the relay and take it out.
Are you kidding me right now? All right, well, that's absolute shit luck. Let's take the sniper shot, I guess. So much for the flashbang. All right, well, this mission may be a failure in the long run, because that's just ridiculous. Oh my god. All right, that's ridiculous, man. Now they're gonna go out of flashbang mode, and now it's gonna get even worse. We can't hit the broadside of anything, but they're able to hit their 10% and kill people with them. That's the worst part. We're not able to get the artifact either. That's really frustrating. That's really frustrating. Alright, whatever.
Burning through ammo fast.
Disorientation removed. Now he's gonna get free shots on whatever he wants. That's really 3 for 3. That's 3 for 3, and that's a bad position to be in, I'm guessing. Ugh. And that's gone. Of course it is. Panic's removed, but that's not really helping us too much at the moment. Got 2 turns of the data transfer complete. I can't believe they got my specialist through disorientation. That's just... levels of bullshit I'm not prepared to deal with right now. Oh, you don't have ammo. Probably should have thought of that. Alright, so now I'm getting a little distraught and frustrated. Alright, this should be a flank for Ziggy, so we'll be able to handle this. No, only 70%. Come on. There we go, there's the kill. Okay, so no artifacts and another lost soldier. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. We're gonna have to really move in and hit that thing down, because that data transfer's coming. And I don't know if I can actually sniper fire that data transfer node.
On the move.
Let's get our sniper back down here, since she's gonna have to get moving and rejoin the rest of the crew. And now it's kind of a race for time. One turn until completion.
Transmission signal is fading. They've almost completed the transfer. This is your last chance to take out that relay.
Well, if we had hit our shots, we would have been able to nail the transfer down. But right now, is this gonna give us eyes on the thing? What the hell? Oh, this is going to be mission failure, isn't it? Oh, that's going to be sad. So, are you on the top floor or the bottom floor? Where is the transfer actually? No, it's the bottom floor, right? So, if I come out here through the window, why can't I see the thing? Do I have to get right up to it? Oh, God. Alright, so I'm pretty sure if I had our hacker alive, we'd be able to do this. But right now, as it stands, we have no ammunition, so there's literally nothing I can do about this. There's quite literally nothing I can do about this. Alright. Well, that's awfully shitty.
Affirmative. Moving out.
I mean, I'll try to get near it, but I think at this rate, we're just not going to be able to stop that dark event. And that's really, really sad. Oh, man. I'm so sore about that shot through the freaking... through the flashbang, man. I mean, I can't do anything about this. I can't fire at it. Apparently, I need to be up next to it or something.
We're close.
Yeah, we're close, but... And we got advent. Holy crap. All right, we're going to have to evac out of here, I think. This is ridiculous. This is getting too hot. This is getting way too hot right now. Well, pistol overwatch is all we can do. Ziggy, reload it and just forget about the goddamn objective, because this is not going to happen. It's officially not going to happen. Oh, man, the luck. The RNG, dude, seriously. Dat RNG, though. I just call for extract. This is just insane. Let's even get the rookie out of here. I don't know. Maybe he can yellow move to here. We're probably going to have to call for Skyranger. Yeah, we're gonna get that evac moving. We're gonna overwatch for now to cover our rookie, and then we're gonna try to get out. Because the mission's a failure, I don't want to lose everybody I have here. We're gonna panic him. That'll be hilarious. Yep. Tank just got panicked. Yeah, this mission just went to hell in the hand. Oh, good. You actually moved to a position that. Is smarter. Shots aren't any better. What is next in the cavalcade of suck?
Commander, it's too late. The aliens have completed the transmission and closed the connection. We missed our chance. We failed to stop the aliens' transmission, Commander. But we can still secure the
I'm getting out. It's not worth it.
Here.
I am getting out. Oh, that's so sad.
Eliminate all hostile contacts.
I mean, there's literally nothing I've got that I can do that's useful here. Tank is more or less a goner, I think. I mean, there's nothing I can help him with. The flashbangs apparently don't do enough to keep my soldiers alive, so I'm going to extract the senior operators, and I'm sorry, Tank. If you can get to the evac, do it. However... I gotta cut and run here. I gotta cut and run. And I cannot believe that luck, man. I knew it was half cover, but that was the whole point of the goddamn flashbang. And... Just get out.
Let's go.
Just get out. Wow. Oh, what a mission. It was going well for a bit there. We handled the snake okay. It's
moving
just... Goddamn. Extract. And, buddy, panicking is not good. He may go down here, but I hate to leave you like this, man. I really do. But you kind of lost your mind there for a second, and bad things happened. What are you doing? What is this Ecto doing, actually? You double panicking him or something? Oh, you're trying to raise a zombie. These Advent Troopers are going to get tanked down, though, this turn. There's nothing I could have done to save him, pretty much. If he doesn't die, he's going to clear the panic, and he's going to haul ass out of there next turn. That Overwatch, though. Alright, you're going to have to sprint through two Overwatches, bucko. If you die, you die. If you make it, you're going to have to make it now, Hank. This is literally what you're going to have to do. You're going to have to make it. All you got.
Already there.
So now I had eyes on the little device thing. That's interesting. Oh, tank. Come on, buddy. Yeah. They're going to hit everything. Of course they're going to hit everything. All right, well, we're evacing everybody. Oh, man, what a failure. What a failure.
Commander, we failed in our mission.
Yes, we did.
We'll need to review our tactics and improve going forward.
Yeah, how about we engineer those flashbangs to actually, you know, flashbang. Oh, that was sad, and that was frustrating. Okay, well, the RNG screwed us that time. Absolutely screwed us that time. And we had no RNG luck on our own side. None whatsoever. Yeah. That's kind of how I feel. How she's acting is how I feel right now. I don't know. I felt like that was going well, and we were doing all the right things, and it just was not lining up for us at all. Okay, well. Oh, we lost this freaking senior specialist. Oh, so Setter, sorry, you're not going to get a customization. We're just getting rolled now. We're just absolutely getting rolled. Well, I mean, what are you going to do? You pick yourself up, you dust yourself off, and you learn some more, and then you move on. But yeah, the most frustrating thing about that is not like I made bad moves necessarily. It's just those flashbangs didn't do what it needed to. Like, it really didn't do what they needed to. Got some bad misses. All the 74% early. Snake dodged my shots and blow my grenades. Like, everything, it was really just a comedy of errors that led to that final result of horrible, horrible things happening. And now our Grenadier is out of action. So this is rapidly becoming untenable. Like, we are literally not doing so good. Long Watch is alright. I think since we're going to be in the position where we're going to need to be in the thick of it pretty quick, I think we're going to take the return fire and kind of go gunslinger early on for Wild Child. Kind of the nature of the beast. We'll do the return fire build, I think. But as for everyone else, man, you don't feel good about a mission like that when everything goes wrong. Yeah, I should improve our tactics, buddy.
Commander.
And Ziggy is shaking.
Stress of combat can yep. shake up even the best of our soldiers. As long as we
civil
keep
commission
healthy,
is staying healthy.
I'm sure they'll recover given time.
All right, what does that mean? Does that mean no damage or just nothing that causes you to get time lost? So that was really sad. That was really sad. We lost two more soldiers on that. Yeah, I know. It's shit. All right. So let me get the supplies. We were supposed to get supplies from that mission. We're not going to get any.
Avenger plotting new course.
So let's get that at least. I mean, we have some surviving soldiers at this point. Let's scan a bit. At least our guerrilla tactics school is going to be up in 3 days, and that'll be a small benefit.
Commander, we have a
what
priority.
Do you want? Seriously, dude.
Hello, Commander. It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar. I believe the black site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
All right, well, that's our goal, is to stop the Avatar project. There we go. Current progress. Let's see.
If they finish what they've started, it sounds like it'll be the end for all of us.
Fair enough. The Avatar project. It's got one, two, three pips up? Three pips up already. I guess it may be the impossible part of this. And the dark events are active because we failed that last mission. Oh, man. Well, let's get to at least... Let's end on a high note in the sense of let's get the Guerrilla Tactics School done. It's one day. Let's at least get that built. The one crowning achievement of this entire LP. More research.
This outcome, though it is intriguing.
What happened?
Despite a thorough analysis, I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent hybrid soldiers' enormous eyes provide. Testing their visual acuity will no doubt prove difficult.
Huh. We get a battle scanner where we just rip out one of their eyes and throw it down there? It's funny. All right, cool. Well, that makes sense. We can use this to identify abominations. That may be useful on Terra missions in the future. So we'll probably go to Resistance comms. Maybe we'll try to get a look at that black site. But at this rate, man, I don't know if we have the troops to even handle the black site. Let's start researching Resistance comms.
A number of valuable applications.
Can we please just get
this technology? I'll have a report
Guerrilla Tactics up
as soon as the research is complete.
Thank God. All right.
Now operational.
Finally, we were able to train our rookies up into units that we need, and we are going through losses freaking hand over fist, man. Some really crap luck. So, soldier required. Yes. Who is the next in line, actually, in our armory? Is that just the normal order? Yeah, next one will be Professor Pitaway. So we'll get Professor Pitaway training up to be, specialist, I guess? Well, someone requests a specialist. Stupko requests us being a specialist. I don't know what Professor Pitaway wants to be. Let's get someone training, because I know we have a particular choice. Well, I mean, they got Rolotter in this order. I feel a little bad. Let's get the professor up here. Learning to be a specialist, yeah? I think that'll be fair, as far as timing goes. No, armory. Where is the girl? There we
you
go.
You lived in one of the colonies for a few years before linking up with Central, right?
Yes, one of the advantages of working with Advent. On the surface, it was very comfortable. But there was a price for that comfort.
The millions of people in those cities don't seem to mind all that much.
Yes, but Advent is always watching. Between their forces and the aliens themselves, they see everything. Not to mention the automated systems. There's nothing quite like providing identification to a lamppost.
What is the cost for upgrading here? 125 supplies and 2 power, so there's no way we're going to be able to get that. Okay, so we need to... I guess we're doing that now. Let's build up the Advanced Warfare Center. Let's move our engineer. No, our engineer's not here right now. Please leave a message. After the beep. So go in here. James White. Yeah, I want you on there, buddy. And let's make this go faster. We need more engineers, badly. But with missions like that, man, I don't know. Can't do much about it. So, for now, I think we're going to call it there, guys. Kind of a negative note to end on, I suppose. After a failure like that, when RNG does not go in our favor. But hey, you know, it's XCOM. That's life. We're going to keep fighting. And we'll see how far we get. This is our first go at Iron Man Legend. You know, maybe we'll crank it down a notch next time and try to learn more of the mechanics before we go in the deep end anyway. But we'll do what we can. Bradford, you talk a lot, man.
Boost in any speech.
Yeah, confidence. You see where that last mission went? I don't think anyone's confident right now. So, I have been Nurse. Until such time, I will see you all then. Till then.